Ah, there we go. We've got it. Let's have some sound as well. Oh, God. What the heck? Actually, let's not have some sound. That was all. No, okay, we'll have some sound.
帝国一度防守给秘密战队造成了很大的困扰，他们当时觉得会自己处于一个怎么样的状态，在僵持局面的时候。
In the last game, Empire put up how the defense. How did you feel in that situation?
Sorry again, repeat.
In the fourth game, Empire gave their best in defending their base. How did you feel in the situation?
There you go, lads, just fixing it for you. Taking the CS4's beautiful face. Oh, sorry.
It was actually a pretty hard game for us.We just needed to find the opportunity for
us. Oh, Winter, what are you doing?
其实找到最高潮的时候是挺困难的，整场比赛我们都觉得非常困难，只要找到机会就上他们的高地了。
What are you saying? Volume. What have I done? Louder. You want it louder? Sorry. Yeah. I'll turn it up. Sorry. Apologies.
在高地下被击杀了多名大哥。那我们也想问一问，在第三场比赛的时候，我们是注意到，其实秘密战队很少会犯这样一个被翻盘的错误。他们觉得第三局原本自己把优势打回来之后是怎么样的一个情况，
导致自己
失去了这场比赛的胜利
？It's
really rare for Secret to lose a game through a comeback. How did you feel in the third game when Empire slowly fought their advantage back into the game?
I have to give them credit, fully credit for that win. They played amazing.
Empire 绝对玩得非常棒，我需要给他们完全的，就是所有功劳。
在这几场比赛当中啊，我们其实注意到 S4 在包括 Artize 在中路几乎占到了所有的优势，在每一场比赛当中，中路几乎都压制住了对手。那我们想问一下，包括再来评价，觉得自己。队伍在中路的一个表现是怎么样能够体现出这种统治力的
？In all your games, either Artizi or S4 has total advantage in mid lane. How do you do it?
I think Team Secret just has some of the greatest players in this world, which clearly shows when they go up against you know lesser players in mid. Yeah.
我觉得秘密拥有全世界最好的中单。所有的选手都是最好的中单，所以对上比较弱的选手的时候，只能是这样的结果了。
好，那我们现在看到了他们霸气无双的一面。接下来想问一下 Papi 哥，在最后一场或者是最后几局较量当中，他擅长使用的英雄几乎都被ban掉了，他怎么看待这个情况
？In the later matches, all the heroes that you're good at were banned. How did you feel about it?
Same old, same old. Shen Enchantress gone, Caudle, Crystal Maidens, everything. Pretty used to it, so it's pretty good to play like that.
都很正常，所有什么擅长的冰女啊、陈啊，全都被ban了。
看来 Papi 已经对这种自己被对方全方面针对的局面已经非常习惯了。那么接下来我们要问一下 Crocky， 作为全世界范围内拉比克使用的最好的、最出色的选手之一，在刚刚这两场对决当中。对方帝国战队拉比克其实起到了一个中流砥柱的作用。那我们想请他评价一下，在帝国的最后两场比赛当中，他认为对手的这个拉比克是怎么样评价他的
？Crocky, known as the world's best Rubik, how would you rate Aloha Dance's Rubik in the last two games?
9 out of 10.
满分是10分的话，我给9分。
那他自己觉得他打出来。哪几局比赛能够称得上十分呢？那一次帮助队伍战胜 eHome 算吗
？Which games have you ever played as a Rubik? Would you rate yourself 10 out of 10? Would it be the game against eHome?
I don't know. TA3 against Alliance maybe.
我也不知道，可能是 TI3 打 Alliance 的时候吧。
Hello，
我接下来一个问题想问一下，Artize， 我们刚才看到了一局非常让人震惊的 受折磨的灵魂老陆的比赛，他几乎是在十分钟以前就已经接近超神了。他当时怎么会这么积极活跃的去进行一个进攻，而且很早就买了一张回程卷轴在身上，帮助自己在上路打了一波非常漂亮的反杀。他那一局他当时是怎么样的一个状态，能打出这么神勇的一个结果来？
This question is for Arteezy. When you were Lushrak in one of the games, within 10 minutes you were almost godlike. Why did you fight so fiercely and why did you carry a TP so early to help top to fight?
The way we picked that game kind of led me to have a pretty good aggressive opening. Like, there were a lot of opportunities for me to teleport and help the BH get some kills.
我们的盘选人的话其实有很多机会就是抓住对面的，所以我提前很带了 TP 然后帮助队伍。
好的，那么在此呢也非常感谢我们 Secret 战队的五名选手接受我们的采访，我们也再一次恭喜他们赢得了拯救者杯 MDR 国际精英邀请。
Oh. No, come on. Come on. Damn it. There we go.
Come on, that's the end of the night.